Hey guys, and welcome to a new series in Romance of the Three Kingdoms 13, and of course its expansion, Fame and Strategy. My name is NG Paradox, and yeah, I'm pretty excited to be starting a new series in this game. It's a game I don't get to play that often, but you guys, if you've been keeping an eye on my channel recently, I've been talking a lot about my excitement and hype for Total War Three Kingdoms. And with them releasing new trailers and information and stuff, I've just really been getting into the mood and the flavor for the Three Kingdoms period. So I decided to play a new series in this game. I gave you guys the vote to vote on whether you want me to play as Yuan Shao or Cao Cao, because that's the two characters that were the main people in the new trailer for the Total War game. And you guys voted for Yuan Shao. I don't get to usually play as the big characters, so I'm kind of excited. We normally play as random small characters and try and roleplay as them, but today we're going to be playing as a bigger character and trying to change history. Can Yuan Shao live up to what could have potentially have been if he just wasn't so indecisive and meeting such a brilliant enemy as Cao Cao? Very unlucky in those regards, but yes. We're going to be starting Yellow Turban Rebellion. I gave you guys a vote for which scenario, and you chose the Yellow Turban Rebellion. So we're going all the way back to the beginning of the end of the Han Dynasty and seeing if we can change the history of Yuan Shao to make him maybe a man he could have potentially have been. Who knows? I'm looking fun. Who will we love? Who will we lose? What friends will we make? Who will fight for me and who will die for me? And who will become my enemy this time? History is going to change, folks. I'll keep things very normal. I normally go historical. That's what I normally prefer. But we're going to go for long-lived because we know that Yuan Shao does die. So it would be nice for just not to, you know, we're changing history. Things are different this time. Let's see if we can actually, you know, how long we can survive just by our own decisions and know what happened historically. Killed fine female to his officer. It's just nice to have more officers, I guess, as well. Appearance City, we're going to go with historical. I normally might go fictional just to make things a bit different sometimes. We'll go historical. So at least then if we're not going to go historically for the story, how things went, at least where people begin and who we might meet are likely going to be similar people or similar situations that Yuan Shao would have had to deal with. Historical events, yes. We will not force it to follow the trend. We're going to keep it fictional. What decisions will we make based upon the situation we're in? That's how we're going to take it. Everything else, I think, is fine. Yeah. And let's jump right in. And I'm excited. This is going to be fun, guys. Hope you'll join me on the adventure. We'll talk a bit about Yuan Shao and the history of this time period as well, just in case some of you are not so well knowledgeable at this time period and you're looking forward to Total War Three Kingdoms as well. I know some of you might be. But yeah, I'm excited to play a big character for once. It's going to be fun. We never get to do this. Ah, Yuan Shao. I will also just tell you guys before we begin, my pronunciation for some names can be really bad. For some it's not too bad, for some it can be really bad because I might not have heard it or I've forgotten when I have heard it, or I happen to have heard it in the past and it was just told to me wrong. So I do apologize for that, but just keep an ear out for that. It is the time of the later Han Dynasty. Politics were corrupt. Society is in chaos. Caught in the storm, civilians took hope in an ominous song. Ah, China. Look how big it is. The blue sky is on the wane. Next, a yellow one shall reign. Zhang Zhao's words spread far, gaining steam among laymen and stirring a great revolt. The Yellow Turban Rebellion was born. Look at that. So many people upset. Grand General He Jin quickly dispatched troops to quell the rebellion, but found only crushing defeat. Ah, He Jin. Look at that. What is that meant to be? What animal is that? I'm not even sure. The growing rebellion struggled with leadership, swiftly evolving into a mob, which terrorized the public and only worsened their suffering. In this era of strife and disorder, a champion to unite the lands was bound to appear. Is it a cunning hero whose wits and wisdom bring order? The man we must defeat in the end to have any success, Cao Cao. Is it a brave warrior whose ambition and strength will inspire the masses? Sun Jian. Is it a benevolent leader whose faith and compassion grieves for the people? Liu Bei. Or is it a man of a noble family who can't make decisions and his advisors tell him different things and they all sound great and he can't decide and so he dies? Yuan Shao. There you go, that's ours. The Hounds of War were set free on the battlefield of chaos. The era of heroes had begun. And here we go. As raiders from the Yellow Turbans began to threaten Yu Province, Governor Liu Yan posted a call for volunteers. One young man stood staring at it. Ah, Liu Bei. What are you all gloomy about? Are you going to just sit there and sigh while your country falls apart around you? Pathetic. And you are? My name is Fei of the Zhang family. Sorry to startle you like that, but I couldn't just stand here and watch you. I am Bei of the family Liu. I truly do want to help save my country, but I have neither the strength nor the money to do so. That is what depresses me. Oh, now that I see you, you do have a look about you. Come, let's get a drink and you can tell me your story. Excuse me. I beg your pardon for interrupting, but please, allow me to join you as well. From the looks of you, you are someone to be reckoned with. And you are? I am Yu of the Guan family. I overheard two such impressive individuals conferring about the troubles of our land and could not stay quiet. The god of war, Guan Yu. Ah. The three then moved to a nearby shop and shared their past and their desires for the future. They hit it off well and decided to join forces. There's a peach garden behind my house that is in bloom. Before we take off, let's swear an oath to join our strengths and work together. And here we have next one of the most famous scenes, I think. It may be one of the most famous scenes in almost all of Chinese literature, maybe. You know, if you talk to people about the Peach Garden, everyone in China would know this story. And probably a lot of people in, like, East Asia as well. Famous scene. So beautiful. Just the idea of it. Probably didn't happen, but... Beautiful, isn't it? Just such a lovely idea. Just like even imagining it, it just always looks great. Really nice idea. And there we go. Thus, three heroes came together in Yu Province and exchanged oaths of brotherhood in a peach garden and vowed to save the land. I love the way Zhang Fei says his name in that oath. He's like, Zhang Fei! He says it so quick. It just sounds really cool. And in a world filled with powerful lords, they took their first step towards achieving their dreams. And there we go. The three of them swear an oath of brotherhood. You know, even though they're born on different days, they will die upon the same day, hopefully. But here we are, at the Imperial Han Court. Can the Han Dynasty survive this rebellion, or will we all perish? He Jin, though, is taking the council meeting. I must hold council to determine our plan, and wish that you participate. Thank you! Thank you, my liege He Jin. Well, thank you, your great He Jin. I, Yuan Shao, won't let you down. Let our force council begin! First, let us discuss the present situation. So here's the situation right now. We've got He Jin's forces. These are kind of the Han Imperial forces of the Imperial Court. Many of the major characters are currently in this force right now because they are all involved in the Imperial Court. Over in the west, we've got Ma Teng up here and Dong Zhuo. We've also got a few kind of other lords up here, Liu Yan, Ding Wan, and Gongshun Zan, and of course Sun Jian. They're all underneath China, but they just have their own little forces over here. They might help out against the Yellow Turbans, or they could take advantage and try and expand their influence and strength. I'm looking at you, Dong Zhuo. I'm looking at you. And of course, down south we have Xi Shi. He's always just down there. Just always kind of just out of sorts, you know, out the way, basically. So yeah, we need to defeat the Yellow Turbans. They're a major threat right now. We must decide what to do under our current circumstances. Speak now if you have anything to suggest. Liu Biao. Yes, Liu Biao. He lies in the strategic area that He Jin army needs. We should take 5 cities in the area. So he thinks he's going to full assaulting attack against the Yellow Turbans. I would agree with that. What we need now are allies. An alliance of Ding Wan army can only do us good. Who wants to ally with Ding Wan in the north? Okay. I'm not sure that's particularly useful in this current circumstance. I would probably just say to assault, so I'm not going to ask anything. If you don't know that this is us, this is Yuan Shao. We'll talk a bit about him in a second when we look at his biography. The biography kind of gives you the main ideas you need, but you can see he's got very nice armor. Very nice. Now you must vote which proposal to proceed with. I'm a bit worried everyone's going to vote for this just because it's He Jin who proposed it, but really it should be this. We need to take them down. I feel Liu Biao has the right idea. I'm grateful to have your support. Liu Biao's rapport with us has increased. Yes, Chen Yu Chong has agreed with Liu Biao. Cao Cao agrees. Cao Cao knows what he's doing. See, He Jin, that should be your answer right there. Cao Cao agrees. Kong Rong also agrees. Yuan Shu, my cousin, if I remember correctly, he agrees as well. Zhu Jun, he agrees as well. And everyone agrees with Liu Biao. Everyone wants us to go on a full-on assault. I have heard your counsel. We shall follow Liu Biao's plan. It is as Liu Biao says, our priority should be to take Yi immediately. The assignment for He Jin army is to develop city assault. We must all strive to see it done. If I may be so bold, I have some advice. Oh, Wang Yin! You lovely man and your daughter that will come into play in the future. As a minister, yep, he's just telling us how we can play the game. We're done then, so there we go. Now, this is just the beginning. Where will our story take us? Will we defeat the Yellow Turbans? Will He Jin survive into the future, or will the Imperial Hang Court fall apart and the Warlords take over in the future? The map might look quite empty right now, guys, but things will change as the story develops. Events can happen and completely change the face of the map because Lords might be giving out certain lands, or maybe they go independent, etc. That can happen if story events are completed, but we'll have to wait and see for that. I don't mind if things change a little bit. We'll see what Yuan Shao's story is. But this is our character right here. His leadership is pretty good. Pretty good leader. He can lead men into battle. His war, his dueling is not the best, but he's capable if he needs to. His intelligence is okay. And his governorship is okay as well. He's pretty good at both of these, but he's not the best. It's usually about out of 100, I would say. So overall, he's a capable commander. That's probably the best way to describe Yuan Shao. He's capable, but he's not that man he's not that next level hero, you know, like Cao Cao or some of the other characters we meet. There's just something missing here, some spark about him. If you met him, you'd probably think he'd be that man for glory, but he's missing that spark, I would say. Sad tale. In another history, in another life with different opponents, maybe he could have done well, but maybe just was never destined to be. Other than that, we'll look at his bio. Son of the prestigious Yuan family. So he's from a very, you know, privileged background, who led the coalition against Dong Zhuo. Afterwards, he fought for domination of the Central Plains with Cao Cao, but was ultimately ruined by his indecisiveness, suffered a great loss in the Battle of Guandu. Yeah, everything just led to the Battle of Guandu between Cao Cao and Yuan Shao. Whoever would win that would likely go on to dominate possibly the entirety of China. And at the time, it was pretty even. I don't think before the battle, anyone would probably say who would win. It was pretty even, but Cao Cao came out on top. And so Yuan Shao was made into history, basically. He just got left into history, and he died, of course, as well. not a happy story. I think we are married. Yeah, we are married to Liu Shi, and we have a couple of sons, if I'm correct, but I don't think they're old enough yet. So we won't be meeting them right now, but let's get some comrades. Get my wife. Add her in. Let's look at her info. She's okay at governing. She's got okay intelligence, but that's really it. She's not really going to be fighting anyone one-on-one. Not something we should really be doing with her. A concubine to Yuan Shao and mother to Yuan Shang. After the Battle of Guandu, she suggested that Yuan Shao make Shang his successor. When Shao died, she plotted with Shen Pei and others to make Shang the new ruler. Her first step in this was to have the other five wives killed. So she's a pretty ruthless lady, you know? She's pretty ruthless. She makes big moves, you know? Maybe not the same as Yuan Shao would. I shall fight for the sake of our land by your side, Yuan Shao. But for now, she's backing me for now until I die. Maybe then she'll cause a problem. Currently, we're in Luoyang, the capital of China with the imperial court. This is where the emperor is. And we're the war minister. So I'm high up in, you know, I'm high up in the Han court, you know? So pretty good for us. We should probably get some more people. Higher, maybe? Nah, we don't need a higher person. There's probably a lot of personnel here right now. We know things are probably going to change. We need to get the military ready for the war coming. Patrol. Let's actually train troops. Let's train troops instead. In Luoyang. Let's get the spearmen done. How about... Cao Cao. How about you go train the troops? There we go. So Cao Cao has been sent to train troops. He was a good trainer, apparently. And for now, then, we'll wait for battle to begin. Oh! Luoyang's council was held in Chenlu, allowing me to report on the results. The council determined Luoyang's assignment is strong domestic. So the city wants strong domestic right now. But that's it. Who are the people in charge of these, then? We're going to be going quite detail on this. I hope you guys are joined for the journey. I will be going into lots of detail. We got Yuan Shao controlling the capital. Lu Ji controls this. Kong Zhao controls that. Hong Fu Song. I've always been a fan of Hong Fu Song. Han Fu over there and Lu Yu over here. So those are kind of the guys who've been given the governorship. But, you know, I'm the minister of the capital. So, you know, it's pretty good as well. The Yellow Turbans, though, we've got Bo Ke. We've got Zhang Bao. Zhang Liang. Zhang Mancheng. Lu Pai. Guan Hei, we have Zhang Yang, Zhang Jiao, and of course Cheng Wangji. All of them there. We can go on to the forces actually as well. That'll be give us a good idea exactly how things look. Obviously, Heijin's the biggest force. There we are. There's his council. Wang Yung, Zhu Jun, 104,000 men currently right now. Yellow Turban, that's his council right now. Not the best of people. He's got a ragtag bunch of individuals all kind of put together right now, I guess you could say. And there we go. Gongshun Zan. Zhang Yang. Lu Bu, of course. Oh, dear. That will probably change. These things are all going to change a lot, though, in the coming time. So let's go into free speed. We'll let things go quite fast, because right now, I think both sides are going to build up. And when they're ready, the forces will probably come together. Until, I guess we could make some friends, maybe. We'll probably make some friends or goodbye. We haven't got much money. I got kids coming. I don't need more kids, really. We know you want to show us kids. I guess if I go to my house, maybe I can actually see them. Oh. Ah, Yuan Shao, the eminent general. How about a game of Go with an old man once in a while? Okay. Techniques in Go apply to techniques on the battlefield as well. How about this move? Finish things quickly or take... I think Yuan Shao's the man who takes his time. Because we know he can't always make his decisions. So I feel like he'll be patient. He always takes too long to make to do stuff. I see a good move. You've got me. Excellently done. Slow and steady won the race. So it worked out for Yuan Shao for the game ago. So maybe it can work out. But let's see if we can go to our house. Hello, my dear wife. We can't see our children. Yes, I can't see my children. I'm going to have to wait till they get older. Okay, just making sure. I know when you make kids in the game, you can go see them and stuff and choose their education. But I guess because our kids are already kind of been born, they're already characters, it's not old enough yet. I know you're just the one for the job. Would you help me with my investment? Of course, my dear wife. Of course I'll help you. Not helping my wife. What type of man would I be? Yeah, I'd be Yuan Shao maybe, but... No, Yuan Shao I think would help his wife. Well, the other lord's gonna help. Or the other lord's gonna take advantage. They're gonna help against the Yellow Turbans? Or they're gonna try and gain more power across the land? Meng Guang has been hired. Okay, that's done. She's thanking me for my help. No problem, my dear wife. You're my wife after all. We will get some more. Maybe let's go on the attack. 22,000 men. The Yertumans do have quite a lot of men, though. Let's just train some more men. Get some more spear done. Cao Cao again. He's just got such good training. Yeah, he agrees with me. See, Heejin just likes it. He's like, yeah, let's get Cao Cao to do it. Ah, you won Shao. A new scroll came in. Do take a look. What is this? It's the one it's one I truly have to recommend to you, being the eminent general and all. How about just giving it a read? Oh, and this scroll too came in recently. The top one, the middle one, or the bottom? Yuan Shao would never choose the bottom one. It's touched the floor. He's too proud to do that. One on top? I know, I think maybe he'll think too much and choose the middle one. Yeah. I think he'll think about it too much and be like, you know what, the top one's too obvious, the middle one. This is just a normal scroll. Oh, well, there you go, Yuan Shao. Great, good for you. 5 leadership has been gained from that, okay. We do need to tap the city soon. We're trying to think where it would be best to assault from. I guess we'd want to come to here. 20,000 men. With 22,000, it would not be enough. The earned honors? Okay, Chao Chuan has come out on top. Zhang He, there's Zhang He. Hopefully we get to see a lot of people that did help Yuan Shao. But who will be the ones who help me this time? In this alternative history, who will be the people who will help me on my push to stardom? Oh, Cao Cao. You want me to help you train the spears? Maybe we can become friends. Maybe we can become friends this time. Give you gain if we could somehow appoint Shao Xing to our army. Yeah, I agree. Send Liu Yu. Very well, let it be so. See, Heejin, he's liking me. Stay on his good side. Investigating Liu Yang. Yep, go do that. He's asking me about everything. He loves me. He loves me. He thinks I know everything, basically. He wants to ask me all his problems. Hopefully we can answer them for him. We'll get on his good side. We'll be closer and closer to the Emperor. Heejin is not the Emperor. Heejin, his sister, is married to the Emperor, if I remember correctly. I always forget the relationship, but yes. It's something like that. But he's in charge of the armies. Free training mission, report Cao Cao's gone up. I cannot thank you enough. Thank you, Cao Cao. See? We could bring Cao Cao in. His rapport's gone up. Ooh, a letter of invitation from Cao Cao. Looks like we're becoming quite good friends, Cao Cao. Thank you for taking your time out of your busy schedule to visit me. Could I interest you in a game of Go? This is just like the bloody trailer now for Total War. This is what they did do. I feel like I understand you much better now. There we go. I'm not sure that's a good thing, actually. Having Cao Cao know who I am and who I'm like, that's maybe not a good idea. Maybe you don't want that, Yuan Shao. Oh, Yuan Shao, soldiers come to me this time. I'm training this one in martial arts, but the second I take my eyes away, hey, you! Keep your eyes in front of you when you hold your weapon at the ready. And this is how it's going. Oh, Yuan Shao! Could you watch over us? Then I'm sure. Thanks to your help, Yuan Shao, he's grown so much. I must thank you. Well, there we go. We've helped out with the army. We gained some leadership there. We probably do need a bit of leadership anyway, so that's kind of good to get. Get even more leadership, make him the best commander he can be. If we could appoint Shao... Yep, you've already asked me that. Go get him again. You obviously failed the first time. Try it again. Mao Ji has been hired by Shun Yu. There's some very good, you know, generals and advisors around here right now. But right now it's very peaceful. Everyone's kind of building up for the conflict. Oh, again, it's the same one. Oh no, this is a duel. Left my village, my friends. Hoping to become a soldier. But we don't know the extent of our abilities. Could you test our abilities, those skills of yours? Okay, time to test my fighting skills. Here we go, I'm slightly better. Come, let us do battle. Be honored, you battle Yuan Shao! Bit too boastful there, Yuan Shao, maybe, but, you know, I get it. That's what he's like. Okay, unbalanced there. Well, we'll go with... We should probably attack against that. So let's go... Defend, attack, attack. Unbalanced knockout. There we go. Okay, defend Yuan Shao. Good, perfect. Now attack. Ah, he defended. Okay, now attack. He's going for unbalanced. Should be okay there. Good, good, good. Now defend, please, you. Oh, he went attack this time. But I'm going for the knockout blow. Take this. And we both went for knockout blow. So I just won. That was pretty close. I'm out of your league. Well, maybe that's a bit thrown it. That's maybe going a bit too far, Yuan Shao. But okay. Probably choose to become more. Perfect. Okay, not looking too bad. Fang Yu has been hired. So we're hiring a lot more people, more officers for now. But yeah, if a war did happen, we'd not be in a great position. They've got a lot more men kind of on the front lines. We've got like 13 here, 12 there. Yeah, it's not great. Du Ji has been hired. We need to be careful. We need to defeat the Yellow Turbans, bring order back to China, get the Han Dynasty, you know, into safety. Let's go and patrol some places. Who likes to patrol? Oh, Cao Cao, your patrol's amazing. That's getting Cao Cao to do everything. Yeah. Sorry, Cao Cao, but you're going to be too busy, you know, patrolling. This is how you make your way up, Cao Cao, you know? You got to make your way up, you know? You weren't born to such a prestigious family as mine. Obviously, Cao Cao was still born to a high-up family. I think people, when they compared Cao Cao and Yuan Shao, obviously they all remember that Yuan Shao was from a very prestigious family. But Cao Cao was still from not a bad family. It wasn't like he was on the streets or anything. He rose up. But it is thanks to his ability as well he was able to rise up. Ah, Zhang Hong. But he was from a pretty decent family. That's how he got into the Han Imperial Court in the first place. Oh, another scroll apparently. We'll choose the middle one again. What is it this time? It isn't readable. I've wasted my time. Well, there we go. What a waste of time. Perfect. Perfect. 23,000, 21,000. If they sent more men to help them, we wouldn't be able to take it then. It'd be a waste of time. We're going to wait for the full-on assault. I'm going to wait for He Jin to demand the full-on assault. I mean, we got to do this soon. We got to do that soon. That is our focus, to attack these cities. So I'm hoping we'll attack at some point. No one else though is moving. Usually the AI takes a little bit of time before they go on the assault, just to get you prepared. Yuan Shu is holding a banquet. Fine, I'll go to my cousin's banquet. It's nice to come to a banquet to relax once in a while. We've met Han Hao. Well, oh, thank you. Nice to meet you. Han Xuan. Oh, Han Xuan. You're actually here in the Imperial Court at this point in time? Okay. Yuan Shu, of course. This is his party. And that's all he invited? Just us three? Yuan Shu, come on. Can you get more people? Who are currently in the city right now? You've got my wife, Cao Cao, He Jin, Liu Biao, He Shi, Wang Yun, all very important people. This is kind of like the who's who. Zhu Jun, Kong Rong, which makes sense because, you know, this is the capital right now. Oh, a couple of people actually aren't in the court right now. That's why they came. And Yuan Shu does not like me, though. I'm not getting on well with Yuan Shu these days, you know. We may be family, but we're not really getting along. Okay, my wife, don't worry, I'm coming. We're not getting along these days. We've had some of our differences. And yeah, Yuan Shao and Yuan Shu have definitely got some differences. Oof. Oof. I'm really hoping both of them will be in Total War. Three Kingdoms. I'm thinking Yuan Shao has to be because he was in the trailer. But they did mention Yuan Shu in another gameplay trailer. So they mentioned his name. So I'm hoping he'll be in it. He has to be. He has to be. He goes and calls himself Emperor. It's great. Hong Fu Song, still the same people as before. Can I let time go by? It's not the time for moving yet. There'll be a time when the air will suddenly all just start moving, and everything will just explode. They'll all do it around this. There we go. See, Dong Zhuo, he's the first one to move. So he's expanding to Anding. So Dong Zhuo decided to take advantage of the situation, the rebellion, and expand his forces. Suppressing. There we go. Deploy, we're going to attack Yi. Let's go, yes. He Jin, now is the time. Thank you. He's ordered me to lead forces to capture Yi. Okay, so me and Cao Cao will lead on my wife and I think that's Cao Cao's wife. So we're both taking our wives. And I've got, Zhu Jun. And he's got Chen Yu. Fine. We shall head off. Oh, look at that, look at all the armies. It's a full-on assault. Here we go. There is no defeat for Yuan Shao. He Jin has dismissed Yuan Shao's minister. What? Oh. Okay. Hong Fu Song wants to now make me his military minister. Okay. All right. So I've now become the military minister for the Viceroy Hong Fusong. So Hong Fusong is now the Viceroy of China. Comrades were disbanded. Okay, so something's obviously changed. They've obviously made a Viceroy. So we'll go quick look at districts. Hong Fusong has been given basically every city apart from the capital. He Jing controls the capital, and Hong Fusong controls the other cities. And it looks as though he's now made me the minister for Hong Fusong. There we go. Okay. So that's what happened just there. So I've now moved actually to Chenlu. We've gone there with Hong Fusong, who is, you know, an important man. He's an important man. There we go. Hong Fusong. Very good leader. Look at that. 89. Minister of Late Han. During the Yellow Turban Rebellion, he defeated Zhang Liao and Zhang Bao with a fire attack and desecrated the grave of Zhang Jiao, stealing the corpse's head. Doesn't sound like a nice man, does he? Took some time off, but returned to the court after Dong Zhuo's assassination, became a grand commander. But yeah, he's a pretty good one, actually. Here we go, full-on assault. So I'm living here right now. I get my wife back. There we go. Perfect. Get my wife back in there. The war's begun. Sun Jian is expanding there as well, so some of the warlords making their moves, but let's go. We march north. Ye must fall. And battle begins. So we got Liu Ji, he's leading the first force against Bo Ke. He's got more men, but they are getting reinforcements. Zhang Chao should be getting there quite soon. Hong Fusong has been chased by the Yellow Turbans from behind. And there's Yu Du. Oh, I did an entire series on Yu Du. Oh, Yellow Turban army marches to attack the capital with 32,000 men. Oh no. So we're attacking them, they're attacking us. It's full on war currently. Okay, here we got 29,000 men versus 17,000. Hong Fusong, though, has the advantage with his good officers. Zhang Chao, though, is attacking the city. Pretty even. He has got against Zhang Yan. Zhang Yan has a slight advantage, though. He's better officers, and he's got slightly more men. So Zhang Chao needs help right now. We need to get these guys there as soon as possible. Yu Du's bringing 3,000 men. They should be able to defeat this, and I hope we can go take that as well. I'll be bringing in more men as well with 19,000. Let's go. Crush them between us. And there goes Cheng Wangji. How's the capital, though? Yeah, sending these men in. 17,000 men there. Yeah, we got to be careful. But here I am. I will take control. We go to battle, men. The war begins. Learn what happens when you defy me, says Cao Cao. Okay, so we join in the middle of the battle. Cao Cao is currently in charge of this assault against Zhang Bao, who is one of the brothers of Zhang Jiao. So he's an important officer. If we can capture him, that could be useful. I'm currently over here with 9,000 men. There's Cao Cao. Got the other forces over here. We have this. We can go capture that. They got a lot of men there. We got a lot more men there. So how about I go attack this? Let's go take that then. These guys can handle them. Got Zhang He, Hong Fusong. This guy is Bao Xin. Some good generals here. This is why I like the Yellow Turban Rebellion, because in the Imperial Court, there's some really interesting generals. So they're going to fight here, maybe. Oh no, Zhang Bao is escaping. They got those archers. But they're just going to go straight for the main camp. If we take the main camp, we win. Zhang He has taken that tactical point. Go Zhang He. Hopefully we can get him later. He was a commander for Yuan Shao, but then Cao Cao. But he's I really like Zhang He. Okay, they're taking that. So they're retreating to go help. They're getting caught by these guys. Now, overall, number-wise, they're almost dead. 10,000, 13,000. Yeah, they should be fine. They don't need me to go in. Cao Cao's just protecting the main camp for now. And I've almost got this. Bo Ke is out already. And the morale's gone down. And here the battle begins. I've suppressed the camp, so I should probably go and help as well now. We don't need to take that. This battle's won. Let's go attack them from here. Go attack you do. Yeah, these guys are dead. Once all these guys are dead, we can then go help the city be captured. Let's go. The great Yuan Shao is here to save you all. Here we go. Without me, they would have all died. Zhang Bao has been defeated. You do slain by Hong Fu Song. Oh, wow. I did a whole series of him and he's dead. Well, there we go. Hong Fu Song, badass he is. And there's one left. Let's go take him down. And he's got 300 men. And this should be it. Just got in time there to fight. And they're done. Battle's over. Victory. The hosts of heaven are mine to control. Okay, Cao Cao, you know, take it back a little bit. Hong Fu Song, I was okay. But Hong Fu Song was the top one. Of course he was, of course. Just wait. See all these great commanders interacting together. I love it. I love it. But now we've taken that, we can move on to the city, not the capital. We can move on to Yi. Zhang Hong and Zhang Chao are having a bit of a problem there. And there's like 20,000 more men. Zhang Jiao, though, is leading men himself here. So we need to go take him down. What else has changed? Okay, he's leading men to take this city. He's going to take that city. Sun has expanded. They've expanded. He's expanding there. Yeah, so you see people are making their moves. What happened to the other army? Looks as though the other assault in the capital has been stopped. I guess they were worried about this battle here. Yeah, it's going quite badly. But let's go! Perfect. Look at that. 32,000 versus 34,000. We have less men, but better officers. But I'm about to add my forces in, so we should be winning this battle. And that will be a good position. But I think we're going to end this part here, guys. This part just introduced the new series. I hope you guys have joined me for the journey. What officers will we get? Will we get Zhang He back? Like in history, will we have Yang Liang or Wen Chao with us in the future? Will we try and help the Han Dynasty or will we try and go our own way? And will we be able to defeat the Yellow Turbans in the first place? It's looking pretty good right now. But who knows what could happen and what could change as the battles continue. Hope you guys are joining us for the journey. I'll see you next time. I've been NG Paradox. And of course, he's been Yuan Shao. Have a good day, have a good morning, have a good night, and have a good tomorrow. Yuan Shao rises!